Hello, Nickelodeon fans, and welcome to This Week in Nickelodeon History. My name is Captain Eric, and we are covering everything that either premiered or ended on Nickelodeon from June 20th to June 26th. And we start 2 years ago. On June 22nd, 2019, Lego City Adventures came to Nickelodeon. Based on the Lego franchise and, of course, their Lego City spinoff, Lego City has been one of the central hubs of Lego's advertising and also sets. I think, as far as I know, it's their longest running set, as far as I'm concerned, because, man, when I was a kid, there were Lego City sets, and there's been Lego City commercials that have been super popular all through my teenage years and growing up. So it makes sense to have a cartoon about it. They've already really blown into the medium of animation with the Lego franchise, so it's only natural that, you know, this kind of project would happen. But this is a Nickelodeon show, and I have not seen any single episodes of this. But, you know, I have a soft spot for Lego, so they really can't do wrong in my book. So I can't imagine that this is at least anything less than at least watchable. 3 years ago, on June 25th, 2018, the revival of Double Dare premiered on Nickelodeon. Returning to Double Dare is such a good idea. It's such a simple show to do. It's still super popular, beloved by millions around the United States, and I imagine the world, and even variations of Double Dare. People like seeing messes happen in trivia on television. It's the perfect mix of the best kind of game show you can have. I have such a soft spot for Double Dare. I am blessed to have met Mark Summers on two occasions and attend Double Dare Live on multiple occasions, which was a touring show. While this was airing on Nickelodeon, they had a touring portion, which was kind of aimed to get the adults, you know, to get on stage and do some stuff. They still had kid events and whatnot, but it was a kind of a nostalgia tour with Mark Summers and some of the original Double Dare crew there, which was, it was very exciting because I just, like I said, as far as like game shows are concerned, this is probably my favorite game show of all time and any iteration. And even when Mark Summers isn't hosting the show, which he wasn't on this revival, as it was hosted by Liza Koshy, who is a massive YouTuber, who she began her career on Vine in 2013 and then just came on YouTube when Vine went under and just blew up in popularity. She's just one of the biggest creators on the platform. So it was natural to get somebody like her to host the show. And Mark Summers was still a part of the revival in an important way, so it's not like he was forgotten about. He still had a presence on the show. I only watched a few of the early episodes. I couldn't keep up with it time to time, but it was Double Dare. It really wasn't hard to mess up or like very easy to do. Like it's Double Dare. Have some trivia, have some slopsicle, you know, some physical challenges. And then you got the slopsicle course, you have the slime, you have the mess. Like that's all you need really for a successful Double Dare. The revival only ran for 61 episodes. And there's a lot of creators here. I'm going to go through their names and I apologize if I butcher anyone's name, but these are the listed creators of Double Dare. But we have Jeffrey Darby, Michael Klinghoffer, Dee LaDuke, Robert Mittenthal, and Debbie Bees, who gets specific credit for Family Double Dare, but I'm giving her credit here. Darn it. 5 years ago, on June 25th, 2016, Bella and the Bulldogs finished its run on Nickelodeon. Running for a total of 2 seasons and 39 episodes, the show was created by Jonathan Butler and Gabriel Garza. It starred Breck Bassinger, who played Bella Dawson, who is a Texas quarterback of her football team, the Bulldogs. So, you know, it's the whole female and a male-dominated sport type show. Hey, love the premise. 39 episodes is a pretty good run. Two seasons, not too shabby on Nickelodeon these days. So congratulations there. 7 years ago, on June 21st, 2014, the movie Terry the Tomboy premiered on Nickelodeon. 12 years ago, on June 25th, 2009, Beyond the Break finished its run on The N. If you don't know what The N is, well, we get to talk about it. The N was actually the nighttime block of Noggin. Noggin was a channel that, you know, pretty much ran preschool content all day from like 4 in the morning until like 5 or 6 at night when they would expect parents to be home. At that point, Noggin just turned into The N, which they had more kind of Teen Nick programming on its network. Beyond the Break being one of them, which is a drama series created by Michael D. Jacobs, David Brookwell, and Sean McNamara. It ran for 3 seasons and 34 episodes. That's not that bad. 13 years ago, on June 21st, 2008, Dance on Sunset finished its run on Nickelodeon. It is a dance and music series hosted by Quatus, Benjamin Quatus Philippi, on Nickelodeon that featured dance routines called the Fresh Squeeze Dance, designed to be performed by its preteen and teenage viewers. Choreographer Tony Testa and the show's dance troupe, the Nick Six, demonstrated each routine slowly, repeating it several times during the episode. An advanced version of each routine was featured on the show's website. This is just like, since the form of television, there's always been shows that featured music and dancing as a way to just connect with your audience and get to do something like this. I'm not surprised at all that Nickelodeon tried their hand at this. It ran for 1 season of 12 episodes. 17 years ago, on June 20th, 2004, the show Fatherhood premiered on Nick at Night. You know, the big deal about Fatherhood is that it was Nick at Night's very first original animated series. I think it was kind of smart to finally kind of dip into adult animation, even though this show wasn't anything that was going to rival shows like The Simpsons and Family Guy and South Park. And I've always thought that Nickelodeon should have an Adult Swim or just even something with a bit more of an edge as their night programming. But they've always had the classic sitcom format. People are used to that. It always gets great viewership. So, you know, why fix what's not broken? But the less said about certain aspects of the show, the better. So with that, we will move on. Because 8 years ago, on June 20th, 2003, LOL with The N finished up its run. It ran for 1 season of 4 episodes, directed by Adam Idelson and presented by Mike Birbiglia. I got that pretty close. Mike Birbiglia. He is a stand-up comic, and it is a series of 4 stand-up comedy specials that aired on Noggin's network, nightly programming network, The N. I think this is super smart in a way, you know, to bring stand-up comedy to a slightly older demographic, although not, you know, super adult, obviously keeping it in line with the preteen audience. They obviously didn't see much more in this beyond 4 episodes. So it's kind of a shame there, but I wish this was something they would have kept up. It could have just given, even doing it with kids that are preteen, giving them a platform, a chance to become stand-up comics. That could have been something The End could have really tackled there. And with that, we are at the end of our show. We have a bit of a shorter episode this week. And in some cases that might be a good thing. For those that would like an update on how my weight loss program is going, things are actually still moving forward strongly. I'm down to 305 pounds, which is a big deal. And once again, it's just changing the portions you're eating, changing what you're eating, being smart with the serving size on packaging. I mean, if you look even at a small bag of chips, it usually has, you know, more than one serving size in a small bag. And we're so used to just eating the whole bag instead of just having smaller portions at different times, and not, you know, beating yourself over eating unhealthy once in a while, having, you know, a piece of cake at a party. It just means that the next day you got to work a little bit harder. So July is coming up, which is when they were supposed to be filming The Legends of the Hidden Temple. I don't know how far in advance of the filming that they're going to reach out to anybody. So I haven't heard anything as of yet. But you know, I'm still keeping fingers crossed. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to drop everything to go to LA very quickly. Me and my partner are still training and getting ready for this. So we'll see how things go. Thank you for being a part of this. Thank you for listening. If you can follow us on every form of social media, we now have Linktree active. So if you find us on one, you usually can find the links to all of the others. At I'm Ready Podcast on Twitter, at SpongeBob Podcast on Instagram, where you can follow our links to our YouTube channel, our Facebook page, and all the other goodies that helps us out. So thank you for being a part of this. I appreciate you. Stay safe out there. Get vaccinated. And we'll see you here next week.